Look, neither candidate really answered most of the questions in the vice presidential debate this week. We could have learned a lot that we did not. But there was one particular response from Vice President Pence that would have embarrassed even Pinocchio.
The climate is changing. But the issue is, what's the cause and what do we do about it? President Trump has made it clear that we're going to continue to listen to the science.
It's not clear. It's not clear at all. And it's not true. For instance, climate change, which exists and is a problem, according to science.
So Obama's talking about all of this with the global warming and that. A lot of it's a hoax. It's a hoax. I mean, it's a money-making industry, okay? It's a hoax. A lot of it.
More evidence, according to an extensive database of attacks on science compiled by the nonprofit Union of Concerned Scientists. The Trump administration has reversed or revoked nearly 70 Obama-era environmental initiatives, with many more in the works. They've stopped studying or releasing data or scientific opinions on farm pollution, how truck pollution affects kids, and how some toxic chemicals affect American workers who use them. The president pulled out of the U.S. Pulled the U.S. out of the Paris Climate Agreement to combat global warming. He's eviscerated the Endangered Species Act and drained scientific expertise from agencies across the U.S. government. You likely remember when he rebuffed his government meteorologists by drawing on their map with a Sharpie to extend a hurricane forecast zone into Alabama because he had said it would be affected, even though scientists did not. According to Axios, he once inquired about nuking hurricanes, dropping nuclear weapons on them, and on the topic of water-saving showers and toilets.
People are flushing toilets 10 times, 15 times, as opposed to once. They end up using more water. So EPA is looking at that very strongly, at my suggestion.
And if Trump's quixotic approach to science is too subtle, there's his almost constant refrain on wind energy.
We don't like that building. The windows are too large. Okay, let's rip it down and build a new one. What windows are you going to have? We're not going to have windows anymore. Environmental. So it's, you know, they love wind too, right? The big windmills, I always say, the greatest graveyard in the world for birds. Just walk under a windmill. You will see more dead birds than you will ever imagine. What's happening, including eagles, you know? In California, they put you in jail if you shoot a bald eagle, right? You go to jail, right? These windmills are knocking them out of the sky all day long. It's unbelievable. And yet they want wind. And wind also is it's very hard to store the electricity from wind. So if you go home and you want to watch television because President Trump is on and you want to watch one of his very brilliant State of the Union addresses, if the wind isn't blowing, the husband looks at the wife, says, darling, I'm sorry, you can't watch tonight. The wind is not blowing.
All right, that claim aside, according to the Fish and Wildlife Service, cats remain the biggest threat to birds. Windmills are farther down the list behind coal, oil, and power lines. On the science of COVID-19, who could forget this one?
And then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning?
He's promoted unproven drugs, Trump political appointees, non-scientists, edited or slow-rolled CDC reports. They altered testing guidelines so they were less scientific. They pushed the CDC to make their school reopening guidelines less scientific so they would fit the president's false rhetoric on why it's safe for kids to all go back to school in person. And after scientists and vaccine makers vowed to take the necessary precautions on vaccines, he baselessly said it was because of politics, not science, when it's actually the reverse. His rush on a vaccine is clearly because of politics and not science. Mind you, this list that we've gone through here is far from exhaustive. And when it comes to Trump's reputable scientific advisors, he dismisses and undermines them.
Dr. Redfield confirmed that it looked like November, December, the first doses would be able to be distributed. But then he said that the vaccine for the general public likely would not be available until probably next summer, maybe even early fall.
I think he made a mistake when he said that. It's just incorrect information.
Dr. Fauci's made some mistakes. He's a little bit of an alarmist. That's okay. A little bit
of an
alarmist.
I'm an alarmist?
A little bit of an alarmist. Dr. Fauci at the beginning said, this will pass, don't worry about it, this will pass. He was wrong.
Sometimes Trump likes to play scientist on television, pretending that he's better qualified to opine about science than real scientists. Here's what he said during a visit to the CDC back in March.
Every one of these doctors said, how do you know so much about this? Maybe I have a natural ability.
He also played scientist on the ground in California in the midst of record-setting wildfires, refusing to acknowledge the science that climate change contributes to wildfires.
It'll start getting cooler.
You just watch. I wish science agreed with you.
Hey, well, I don't think science knows, actually.
Oh, science knows, all right. That's literally the whole point of science.